times. This circuit has two ICs, the 555 timer IC and the CD4017 decade counter IC. The CD4017 has 10 outputs, labeled Q0 to Q9. These pins sequentially switch to a high state with each rising clock pulse. You can see here, each time a clock pulse goes up, the outputs from Q0 to Q9 light up sequentially. The enable pin enables the IC by receiving a low signal or simply by connecting to the ground. As shown, when the reset pin is connected to the ground, the sequence progresses from Q0 to Q9. However, when the reset pin is connected to the pin Q4, the sequence restarts after 4 counts because the IC resets when Q4 goes high. The carry out pin provides 1/10 of the clock pulse output, which can be utilized to drive an additional counter for higher counts. The 555 timer is configured in a stable mode to provide clock source to the IC CD4017. We can adjust clock speed simply by modifying the values of resistor R1 and R2 or the capacitor C. In this configuration, each letter is represented by LEDs connected in parallel and driven by a transistor. Make sure the LEDs connected in parallel have the same forward voltage. If they don't, individual resistor for each LED must be used. We can also use 200 ohm resistors in parallel for these three letters. Happy learning!